we're going to take on some properties of logarithms. Here they are. We've got the product property, the quotient property, and the power property. The product property simply says, hey, look, if we have the log of two things being multiplied together, maybe 3 and x, maybe x and y, like this says, maybe it's a number and we split it up, you know, like 18 would be 3 times 6, whatever it is, log of some base of two things being multiplied together is the log of that same base of one of those factors plus the log of that same base of the other factor. So an example for you, log base 2 of 18 would be the same thing as log base 2 of 3 plus the log base 2 of 6, because we all know 3 times 6 gives us 18. Moving on, log base b of x divided by y. Notice that is division, that is a quotient. We get a quotient when we divide. So this is the same thing as the log of that same base of the numerator minus log of the base of the denominator. So here's an example, maybe log base 7 of x divided by 12. Pick whatever you want. It's going to be log base 7 of the numerator minus log base 7 of the denominator. No biggie. Finally, the power property, which may come into play more than any of the rest of them, super helpful. Log of some base of something being raised to a power. Now notice all of that is part of the log. It's not log base b of x and then all of that is being raised to the power of p. It's that power of p is applied to what we're taking the log of. So here's an example for you. Log base 3 of, what do we want? Let's do something unusual, 16. How about that? Now, I'm going to rewrite 16 so it's expressed as a exponent, like 4 squared. Well, notice what happens to that exponent. That p goes out front. So in this case, it would be 2 log base 3 of 4. So we're able to simplify this down a lot. If we see that exponents applying to our x, you know, maybe we have natural log of x cubed. Well, this would be 3 natural log of x. It's just very useful to get that exponent out from inside our logarithm. Alright, let's use these in some unusual ways. Here it says natural log of 54, and notice our instructions say express each logarithm in terms of natural log of 2 and natural log of 3. So in the end, we're basically rewriting this, showing that we understand these properties. Well, 54, how can we break down 54? 54 is 6 times 9. Which is 3 times 2, and 9 is 3 times 3. So I'm just getting this in terms of 3s and 2s. And so right here, I see that 54 is made up of 3 3s, 1 2. So I'm going to rewrite natural log of 54 to be natural log of 3 cubed times 2. Because I know that 54 is 3 cubed, which is 27 times 2, giving me 54. I'm going to break this up first using my product rule. This is 3 cubed plus natural log of 2. That's that first property we learned about. And so this is already in terms of natural log of 2, but this one is natural log of 3 cubed. I'm now going to use my power rule to bring that 3 out to the front. This is 3 natural log of 3. Plus natural log of 2. And now that is our final answer. We have it in terms of natural log of 3, natural log of 2. Over here, we've got natural log of 9 over 8. Well, hopefully you can see we can change this to be 3 squared is 9. Over down here we have 8, which is 2 cubed. So we've got natural log of all of this stuff right here. Notice it's division. I'm going to use my quotient property. This is natural log of 3 squared minus natural log of 2 cubed. Power rule on both of these things to bring the exponents out to the front. This is 2 natural log of 3 minus 3 natural log of 2. And just like that, we've completed another one. We can also use the properties to help evaluate, and we're going to do this again with no calculator at all, just understanding our properties. So first, I'm going to rewrite, or this is log base for 64, fifth root of 64 is the same thing as 64 raised to the 1/5 power. So I'm going to go ahead and move that 1/5 out to the front. I'll deal with you later, 1/5. So this is 1/5 log base 4 of 64. And so think about this. What is log base 4 of 64? Well, remember, a log is an exponent. So think for a second. 4 raised to what power gives me 64? That's what log base 4 of 64 is asking. 4 as a base raised to what power gives me 64? And it's 4 cubed that gives me 64. So this right here is a 3. So this is really 1/5 times 3. I evaluate log base 4 of 64, got 3. 1/5 of 3 is 3/5. Bingo bango. All right, last one we're looking at here. We've got 5 natural log of e squared. Okay? Well, once again, I notice that we have something being squared. We've got an exponent inside of our log. So I'm going to bring that out to the front and multiply it. So this is now 2 times 5 natural log of e minus, again, I'm going to use my power rule, minus 3 natural log of e. So this is 10 natural log of e minus 3 natural log of e. And you know what natural log of e is? Well, natural log is log base e, so e raised to what power is e? 1. Natural log of e is a 1. Again, if you need to see that out, natural log of e is the same thing as log base e of e. And e raised to the first power is e, so this equals 1. So 10 to the power of 1 minus 3 to the power of 1, 10 minus 3 gives us 7. And look how nice that answer is.